Hello, my dear friends. First, let me congratulate the people who have achieved their goals, in these competitive exams. And let me remind the others who did, very hard work, but unfortunately couldn't get through the exams, that something better than this is coming in our way. So don't stop believing in the hard work. When we started, providing guidance, so it looks like many people have either low confidence or frustrated with the repeated failures. So when we started searching for this motivational content, my team advised me to narrate my own story to rejuvenate the people's confidence. So this is a simple try in that direction to give some of the incidents, that turned my life around. So that I hope you people will draw some inspiration from that and regain your confident from my experiences. So first and foremost thing is, look, I will start with my one experience when I was in the 10th class. So on a fine day, I have seen a advertisement, it's offered by these corporate colleges about the free seats. So if one is wondering what is these corporate colleges, intermediate corporate colleges, these are very famous in Andhra Pradesh, especially, to secure good rank in the engineering entrance exam, to go for the engineering profession. But at the same time, these are quite expensive also. And since I am from the poor background, I couldn't afford this one. So that was my first dream, entering into the corporate intermediate college. So once our beloved Abdul Kalam ji said that you have to dream before your dream can come true. So I very much agree with this one. Why? Because if you have a dream to achieve, then your motivation level and dedication is totally at the maximum, and you really try hard to achieve those. So my dear friends, I advise all of you to have some dreams or some goals to achieve, and if that is not enough, dream big. And fortunately, I secured very good marks in the 10th class, and I got a free seat in the intermediate, and I completed my intermediate at free of cost, and I secured very good rank in the engineering entrance exam also. And here again, despite of securing very good rank in the engineering entrance test, I still am not in a position to join any college, including the government colleges. Why? Because these government colleges are very, less expensive compared to the private engineering colleges. In those days, yearly tuition fee for these government colleges was only 8,000, but still I was not in a position to afford that. And this time, actually this particular period from the completion of intermediate to the joining of engineering, this is really, really, very special to my heart. And whenever I look back into my memory lane, this particular period will give immense pleasure to me. So during this period, my parents wanted me to join some non-engineering degree that is nearby my home, so that there won't be any expenditure burden on them. And one of my uncles, who occasionally helped, previously, this time he was very much apprehensive about the expenditure, that we incur in the engineering course. And apart from these two, there are so many counseling sessions also happened to me to persuade me to renounce the idea of doing the engineering course. But amid all these things, I was just thinking about only one thing. So how to get money for my engineering course? That's what I was thinking. Unfortunately, this time this education loan came to my rescue, and the concept of education loan was very new in those days. And if I start telling how I persuaded different people to get this education loan, then definitely it will become a big Bollywood blockbuster. So that's why I'm saving a day for this. So finally, some 92,500 rupees were sanctioned as against the 92,000 I required for my entire 4 years. And if you wonder why that 500 extra, that is for the manager to process that loan. So finally, my trust with destiny started with a love story, love marriage. So don't be excited, that love marriage with the mechanical engineering, because as I always fascinated about the automobiles. And here again, I need to, you know, face lot of discouragement from the people, because so many people thought that mechanical engineering is not a cup of tea for the disabled people. But my dear friends, here I want to remind you, if you have a determination and perseverance, that's it, whole world will bow before you. And I joined in engineering, and of course life is not always a smooth ride. You know, in spite of having lot of investing, lot of hard work and all, one may have some bumpy ride also. And here in this particular thing, I would like to recollect this Game of Thrones series. So how many of you diehard fans of Game of Thrones? I think many of you might be, and I am also, you know, staunch follower of this Game of Thrones. The beauty of this Game of Thrones is there are so many great philosophies and excellent dialogues in this series. And I like this particular dialogue between Jon Snow and Sir Davos Seaworth. So once Jon says like this, "I tried hard but failed." Then Davos replies like this, "You fail? That's great. Now go and fail again." So my dear friends, initially failure may come, but success cannot escape from a determined person. And failure will be afraid of your unyielding trying. So, you know, all of us, you know, including me, anyone can see these failures in their life. And whenever you touch some failure, then you should make it into your learning experiences. And, you know, fortunately, whatever, you know, incidents that I explained in my life, they had come in favor of me. Otherwise, I would have tried my hand in some other field. But remember, I never ever sit back idle and think about the failures. So, I will tell one incident. When I was in the bachelor, so many mechanical companies came to campus placement, and none of them recruited me. But finally, I ended up in Indian Institute of Science, Bangalore. So, the IISc was the next best thing happened in my life. So that's why I emphasized that if you miss something, then don't worry. Something better than that is coming in your way. So I started pursuing my master's in IISc Bangalore, and I always consider this is a new phase where it really, you know, helped me to improve my overall personality. And my dear friends, the great thing about these big institutions is not because of the academic curriculum, but it's because the overall role that these institutions play in our personality development. And one such greatest trait I really liked in the IISc Bangalore is open mind of the professors. So that's how they carry out these researches. It's a complementarity between the student and the professor. In the same way, we as a constant learners should develop this open mind so that we always embrace the new ideas, and then, you know, we enrich our knowledge also, even though it comes from very less qualified person. And apart from this, knowledge, the open mind also help us to reduce our ego and eliminate our negative attitude also. And all these boil down to the basic concept of happiness. And whenever I think about this happiness, actually this is a very interesting topic, and I always ponder upon it. And let's not go into transcendental arguments of the happiness, that is spiritual side of happiness. And here, if you observe one more thing, there are, you know, we always see this, you know, famous dialogue, happily living ever after. promoted by all our movies. They always promote that after achieving some goal, our life will be happy. And that is a false misconception. That is a misconception, and we all buy into that concept. Let's say, so we all think that after getting a good rank, after securing a good rank, our life will be happy ever after. And after that, we think again that, you know, getting good job is our priority. And again, when you enter in a good job, we always think about becoming a project manager or a team lead. So my dear friend, there is no end for this. There is no end for this. So then where is the happiness? What is the happiness and where is this happiness? Where is this happiness? So this happiness is always with us, always around us and with us. And this happiness is each and every moment, it's with us from the beginning. And it's up to us how we make our lives happy. For example, you identify the things that give happy and you make them into habits and include in your daily activities. So by doing so, you will feel, you know, happiness irrespective of your success or failure in, you know, in our career. So my dear friends, I hope you all find out the things that give happiness to you and pursue their happiness as a hobbies. And finally, I was nothing initially. I was just a cripple born into a poor family. But now I'm standing here and giving this lecture to you, motivational lecture. And if I can remember, my dear friends, if I can achieve this much, each and every one of you can achieve whatever dreams you have in your life. So I wish you all the best.